קחי נפשי אס השם. Today, Shabbat, Tractate Shabbat, page 17, I would like to dedicate the shiur, the Daf Yomi, to a very special rabbi. If you look at the schedule of the Daf Yomi, it's on Shabbat, and it's his Yahrzeit. This great rabbi, whose name is Rabbi Klonimus Kalman ben Rabbi Elimelech Shapira. He was the Rebbe, Hasidic Rebbe of Piasetzna. He was the teacher of many thousands of children that perished during the Shoah. He wrote extensively books like Chovat HaTalmidim, Hachsharat HaAvrechim, and more. So in memory of this sacred soul, Kedosh Elyon, I would like to dedicate our Daf Yomi to Rabbi Klonimus Kalman ben Rabbi Elimelech Shapira. I would like to begin with a Daf Tzayin Amud Bet, 16b, two lines from the bottom. But before that, let me share with you some introduction to our study today. Our study today divided to two parts. The first part will be the last phase of the 18 decrees that Beit Shammai made at that time. We explained it in the previous sessions. And we zoom in, we focus on the Halachot Tum'ah and Tahara, the law of purity as far as in the dead body involved. And then the second part, time allowed, we're going to a new phase, which is the new Mishnah, again involved with the 18 decrees, but it's a new subject, which is the disputation between Hillel and Shammai. Let me share with you some word of introduction, which I think will ease the study of this page 17. When it's come to Tum'at Ohel, we explained that there is a tent and there is a dead body somehow in that tent. Three important principles I would like to share with you. And I think if you really get these three principles clearly, the sugya, the subject we're going to study, will be much easier to learn together. First one is called Omed al Amet, which means there is a dead body and someone who's quote-unquote not necessarily physically standing on a dead body, but it can be Ma'ahil al Amet. That apply to many avenues. Some say that it's applied to Shidra, Gulgolet, etc. But it can be even Ad Kezait or Etzem Keseora, which means that it's a dead body that can be in some spot, can be a cemetery, can be other situation, which soon we're going to discuss. And the person is basically stepping on, intentionally or unintentionally, in that spot. Second point, how do you say it? We wish that never happened to anyone. Unfortunately, if you read my biography, you see that I was very involved with different phases when I live in Israel. So unfortunately, the Israelis faced a lot, which called piguim, which means a terrorist come and bomb some place, and you're facing those huge challenges with taking care of pieces of dead bodies. Now imagine, upon this pigua, this explosion, one part of the dead body hit the ceiling and it's attached to the ceiling. Or it happens, I saw it once in Jerusalem, that it was a tree, and while it was a big explosion, some part of the body hit some branches of the tree, which means it stick. It's like the skin part or some part of the body, just as a result of a huge explosion. Now, part of those limbs, it's already glued either to the ceiling or glued to that trees, and a person passed by that spot, which means under the tree or under the ceiling. Since we said that dead body ma'ahil al adam, it's like a tent cover a person, the halacha said bekol shehu, in any amount, makes no difference the size, the length, the height, the bottom, any spot, in any locations, go up, down, right, left, whatever it is. Second scenario. Now the third one, it's if you are in a hospital, a person is in the hospital, is sitting in the hospital, is a patient in the hospital, is visit the hospital, whatever it is, you are in a hospital. And someone in that department, in a hospital, passed. Since there is a kora meshutefet, which means that the roof is joining roof for every inhabitants, for every patient, for every staff, employee, whatever it is in a hospital, it's all become impure. But here is the measurement. The Gemara used the word poteach petach, which means if there is a hole in the ceiling, in the tent, that it's rachav tefach, in a size of tefach. Remember, that's the size of tefach. And we explained many times that all the shiurim, all the sizes, like kezayit, kebeitza, ketefach, all those different sizes is halacha leMoshe miSinai, which means this is halacha that we receive from Moshe Rabbeinu, from Moses in Sinai. So, therefore, as long as you don't have that spot of shiur tefach, everyone there, it's tamei, it's impure. So if you look at the hospitals in Eretz Israel, you see a sign in some of the hospital said, Asur l'Kohanim. The Kohanim, the priests, are forbidden to enter that domain, because if you are in the sealed building, Bait Atum, which means there is no window, so there is no spot, so you call it in Hebrew latum'ah ein me'efo latzet, the impurity has no place to escape. So even the building can be 100 floors, it's already part of that. Airplane pass by, so we said that when it's come to impurity of dead body, it go any place high and any place below. So now you ask me, if you are a Kohen and you're flying and the airplane passed by a cemetery, since we said that it's bokat veola, that the impurity go ha and vioredet la tehom and can go the lowest below, so it's an issue. It's a side note, I don't know if you remember, but several years ago, some passengers of El Al Airlines filed a complaint that they are Kohanim, and while the El Al took off, they went through a Holon cemetery, a cemetery in one of those cities, and they said that the Tum'ah, it's crossed, and if I'm not mistaken, they changed the line since that, to make sure that if it's Kohanim flying, they don't have those issues. But again, these are the three principles, and the conclusion, anything, anyone that became Tameh, the Tum'ah is for 7 days, which means if you touch a dead body and you touch a vessel, you are Ava Tum'ah, and the vessel is Rishon Letum'ah, the first one to become impure. Then you go to the mikveh and it's over. In some cases, soon you see, in rabbinic's cases of impurity, is just 1 day, Harev Shemesh, that day, and it's over. Now with that, all wrap up, Now we can pave to our sugiya and you see how hopefully it's easy to learn it. Two lines from the bottom of page 16. Ve'idach maihi. Since we talk about the 18 gzerot, the 18 decrees that they follow Beit Shammai, which one is the next one? Ditnan. We learn in Mishnah, tractate Aholot, chapter 16. Kol ha-mitaltelim, which means anything that it's a carry. Shehilu alamet, on the top of the dead body, anything, mevi'im et atuma, which means you create a situation that the impurity carry elsewhere. Be'ovi amardea. What is ovi amardea? It was a special, how you translate it in your English, mardea? The goad or something like that?
Goad, yeah.
Goad. Mm-hmm. So in those days, they have, in order to plow the field, they use the mardea. Now, here's the situation. A person go over an area and he is using this goat. And while he using that, he passed by a body. As a side note, we have this Torah portion of Noach. And they said, at the very end of Bereshit, they said about Noach, Ze yenachameinu mima'aseinu mi'itzavon libeinu. So Midrash Rabbah said that before the time of Noach, the hands is one hand with no fingers. And because of Noach, the comfort Hashem granted them with fingers. So the good news is they can use the fingers. The bad news is that became weaker. So they start using mirdat, they start using this type of goad to plow the fields. Anyway, so if it's around this mardea, and he passed by area, so here is the issue. The issue is that anything that it's around and is a three tfachim, so if you pass an area that there is some type of dead corpse, dead body, then it becomes tameh. So the sages have concern that that people feel that if he is purified in passing by something that it's this size of tefach, so therefore the people feel that anything that it's in that size, it's already permissible. So the decree was that it should be a three. Amar Rabbi Tarfon said, "Akapeach et banai, shezo alacha mekupachat." So Rashi explains that here Rabbi Tarfon has so much sorrow to hear and the wrong alacha, and he has such a pain of hearing something that is incorrect, that in our sense, in the literal sense, he said, "You know, God forbid, the curse upon myself I'm taking if you're accepting what they're saying. They are dead wrong." So why? Sheshama shomea v'ta'a, that someone heard that and he made a mistake. Why? He says as follows: Ha'ikar over umardeo al ktefo v'yihel al hakever tim'o oto mishum kelim ha'alim al ha'met. So imagine a farmer who just walk in the field with this goat, with this mardea. Then he passed by a grave or a dead body. What happened now? The mardea, this goat, became impure because it's clear, right? How long? What do you think? 7 days.
Okay.
Now, the fellow, the farmer who carried the mardea, what happened to him?
Bless you.
Thank you. What do you understand?
He would become Tameh.
He also become Tameh. So he understand the farmer that he become Tameh for how long? For 7 days, the same as the other one. Rabbi Tarfon said, wait a second. You have part of a dead body, let's say. You have this Mardea, this goat that passed by. The dead body is the grandfather, Avi Avot HaTum'ah, right? Now the Mardea turned to be Av HaTum'ah. Now the farmer who carried the Mardea, he is now Rishon LeTum'ah. What's the difference in Rishon LeTum'ah? He's only need Aref Shemesh, which means it's just one day. Tosfot elaborate on that. I just give you the abbreviation. Tosfot said, "Kevan de davar pashutu she'adam anogeh betmemet de tamet umat erev." He says, if someone touch a dead body, so it appear that it's one day. ועוד מן התורה, עיקר תמה תומת שבעה משום תמועה בחיבורים. What is that mean, תמועה בחיבורים? That's a little bit sophisticated. Let's trace three guys. ראובן, שמעון and לוי. One, two, three. Three guys. Okay. They are close to a dead body. So Tosfot said, ראובן, he touched the dead body. Now, is that electricity? He touched Shimon. Shimon touched Levi. What happened? This type, it's called Chiburim. They are connected. But Levi doesn't have the same status as Reuven, who touched the dead body. Right? So, Tosfot said, והשומע תואה, לפי שאינו פשוט כל כך דין תומה בחיבורים. He doesn't know that the old din tumah bechiburim. Why it's chiburim? Why it's connected? You have a dead body, you have the mardea, and you have the farmer that touched the mardea, right? So it was a mix up here. He doesn't know. So that's Rabbi Tarfon objection. Amar Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva suggested something else. He said, "Ani ataken shiyu divrei chachamim kayamim." Right? I'll explain it. שיהיו כל המטלטלים מביאים את התאומה על האדם שנוסע אותם בעובי המרדע, which means that all movable cause תאומה to be brought upon a person that carries them in the thickness of a goat, ועל עצמן בכל שהן, because it's only תפח, ועל שאר אדם וכלים, and upon other persons and articles, bepoteach tefach, which means in the size of tefach, because the thing that touch in something that in mahil, we don't worry about a mistake because it's pure. So basically here you see a three different gzeirot, three decree. Kol shehu mahil, anything that it's covered. Mardea, this type that the goal that connected and ma'ahil. So as a matter of principle, the farmer is just one day, Arav Shemesh. And the sages put a decree that tefach, that size metame adam, right? And Rashi said, gzera ekefo mishum ovyo, וכיוון את מתמת לעל כוחך תומה דהוראית על הצריך הרב שמש והוא לא נגע באמת כסבור שמשום אוהל הוא מתמו. So he mixed up the whole idea, but it's basically the whole תפח מתמי אדם is הלכה למשה מסיני. It's one of those principles that we have it משה מסיני. ואמר רבי ינאי, מרדע שאמרו, that's מרדע that said in that משנה, אין באוביו תפח ויש בכיפו תפח וגזרו על הכיפו משום אוביו. So he said that that's the one that the goat that we speak in the Mishnah does not have thickness of tefach, but has the the around size of tefach, and the grab the rabbi decree that outside of the thickness tefach. Ul rabbi Tarfon damar akabeach banai shalacha zo mekupachat batzrulei. So is now rabbi Tarfon have 18 minus 1. Amar rab Nachman bar Yitzchak av bnot kutim nidon barisatam bo bayom. Remember yesterday we talked about the daughter of Samaritans, so that's the one that they made that day. Ubeidach סבר לה כרבי מאיר, because since we, he doesn't hold of the of Yamar Deah, so therefore the drawing water when he draw vessels, Rabbi Tarfon hold both both decrees, so you have all together כרבי מאיר, you have the 18 ואידך, so how they count the whole 18? So they said another brighter. Ham botzer lagat. If someone bring the grape to the gut, so we said it's a wine press. So they step up on those grapes and they make it wine, and they mix up those grapes with the juice. Shamay omer uchshar, right? Because it's like they the same ochel, the same food that connected to water or the others, because that's the decree. Hillel omer lo uchshar, because it doesn't come because of the fellow that did the wine press was involved. It's what happened indirectly. So you can use impure tools without make the grapes impure. Amar lo hillel shamai lidvarecha, according to what you hold, mipnei ma botzrim betara, what's the reason that the grape with utensils are in state of tahara, ve'in moskin betara, and you don't put the oils, why you require grape to use a pure vessels, but when it's come to use for oil you don't do that. Amar lo im takniteni, if you come ask me question, gozreni tumah alaf mal mesika, if you continue on, I'll put a decree also for squeezing an oil, which means na'atzu chevor bet ha-midrash, so they put a sword, meaning that no one can leave, they're now taking a vote, and amru ha-nichnas yikanes v'alitza leitze, which means stop, we're going to make an election, we're going to have a vote. ואותו היום היה הלל כפוף ויושב לפני שמאי כאחד התלמידים. That day הלל was, you know, bang and sitting like one of the students. והיה קשה לישראל כיום שנעשה בו העגל. It was a very embarrassing for הלל. Everybody was going to שמאי. It's like the golden calf, because also people don't listen to Aaron and Hur. So Chatam Sofer said, if they listen to Aaron v'Hur, so the story of a golden calf did not happen. So, v'gazu Shamai v'Hilel, Shamai Hilel put the decree when it's come to wine press, v'lo kiblu minayu, and people did not accept it. V'hatu talmidayu gazu, and then the students of Shamai Hilel came v'kiblu menu, and then they accepted. So that's basically the 12th decree of the 18. My tama, why, what's the reason they put it, this decree? Amar Zeiri, Amar Rabbi Chanina, Gzera Shema Yiv Tzerenu Bekupot Tmeot. They put a special decree that the safeguard against the possibility that someone harvest the grape into the tameh basket. So, because in Hebrew you call it kli tameh choshev mashkin, so therefore if someone is taking it, the grape become impure. Hanicha leman damar kli tameh choshev mashkin shafir. That's good, that tameh vessels render liquid significance, we understand that. Elamanda amar en kli tameh choshev mashkin, the impure vessels hold mashkin, מהי כלמימה? What do you want to say? אמר, אלא אמר זירי, אמר רבי חנינא, גזירה שמבצרינו בקופות מזופפות, which means he put it in the place that they have grape and peach basket that waterproof, and so the water will not leak out. And so because the water will not be lost, so for sure he is happy for the juice that come to the vessels. So that's part of the decree that they put of all the grapes that that's already collected. So here he said Rava Amar, Rava explained another explanation, Gzera Mishum Anoshchot, because he said that that they safeguard again the possibility of clusters that climb together. So usually people separate them. So while he's doing that, some of the juice come out. So even he don't wish that to happen, because he's losing them, but he created this chita, the squeezing, and it's considering like he did it intentionally, and therefore we call it beyadayim nichale. If he does that with his hand, that's it. It's considering like someone did it intentionally. So he said, Amar Rav Nachman, Amar Rav Avuha, Pe'amim she'adam olech lecharmo ledayim migi anavim bevtzira. Sometimes a person go to his vineyard to see if the grapes are ready or not, or lo, ונוטל אשכול ענבים לסוחתו, and he takes a cluster of grapes and he squeezes it to check, ומזלף, and the water dripped על גבי ענבים, on the top of the grape, ובשעת בצירה, when he takes it out from the tree, and that now they can accept tuma, עדיין משקיע לפי אחרם, there's still liquid on the top of them, and we explain many times that when is the wet from that liquid, so then it's already kosher, it's from the basic foundation of the law, it's kosher. ואידך אמר, and what's the other decree? ואידך אמר, תביא רישבה, תביא רישבה אמר שמואל, 17b, Tavi is the one who's is like a hunter. He used to hunt animals and different ways. So Rishba, there's some say that Rishba is the it's just a name, and some say that is Reish Bet Av, which means that it's a naming him. So Amar Shmuel, Av Gidulei Truma, Truma, Bo Bayom Gazru. So he said that the growth of Truma, it's also the decree that made the, that day, the 18. What's the idea of Truma? So if something Truma, sometimes people have a Ein Tzara. They see, oh, the Kohen gets so much, and they're not so happy with that. They like Ein Tzara, they're not so happy with what the Kohen get. Amar Maitama, what's the reason? Amar Rabbi Yechai, Gzera Mishum Truma Torah Beyad Yisrael. Because sometimes people are very greedy, and they are thinking that they're giving the Kohen, it's giving him too much, and therefore he delayed the Truma to himself, and he planted and he ate whatever left. So the Kohanim lose. So in order to avoid that, they make the truma for whatever growth, so people don't have any benefit from delaying the truma. Amar Rava, ide chashida leachi, if you worry about it, afru shenam lo yafreshu. So they you should concern that they even to put the truma properly, they'll not do, because you know, you're afraid that they can delay, etc. So he said, "Kevan de'efshar le'mevat chita achad kedei Shmuel," because you can allow the isur, the prohibition of tevel, by taking one single chita, And it's basically the way that Shmuel said that chita achat poteret et hakeri, that one chita, it's examined the entire keri. Velo kavid, but they didn't do it. Hemunei mehemnei. So you can depend, trust these people, they're going to give the truma kohen. Ela gzera mishum truma temea bida kohen, dilma mashel agaba ad hedei kalkala. Because he may be eat it while there is a truma. Veidach amar b'chi abarami mishmei deula af. What we're going to say in the Kufnun Gimel 153, Mishech Shirich lo baderech, if someone all of a sudden he riding his donkey and it's already Erev Shabbat and he still have a bag filled of money, noten kiso lenochri, so he give it to a non-Jew, so he'll carry for him. So, because remember we studied at the beginning of the Perek that we're not allowed in Rishut Rabim to carry more than 4 amot. So it's also Bo Bayom Gazru, that's one of the 18. Ve'idach, Amar Bali Amar Avimi Sanvatad, Sanvatad is the name of place, Pitan Veshamnan Ve'inayim Uvnotehem. They forbid several things. So if you see sometimes on bread, Pat Israel, right, etc. So it was in those days people who worship idols, so the sages forbade eating bread that made by people who worship idols because they feel that people will intermingle and create interfaith marriages. The oil, the same reason, but Rabbi Yehuda the president took it out because the Gemara sent Avodah Zarah because it wasn't something that spread around. Yein Akum, which is the wine that made by them, again from the chitun, from the marriage, but it's also from the fear of Yain Esech. So it's chitun and Yain Esech, and Bnot Akum. Marry between different Jew and non-Jews. The Torah said in Devarim chapter 7, "Velo titchaten lam," you should not marry them. So that's the so side note. Have relation with the non-Jew outside of the marriage. The Chashmonaim made it as like one of those decrees that you get lashes. And it's for sure apply only in a secret way, but sin'ah. But if it's public, it's Yalach al-Mushem b'Sinai. So that's famous. So anyway, so this what Bali said. Bali, the name of Avimi said, this all the gzerot that they had, kulam, all this, mishmona asar davarde. All the four that we mentioned, is part of the 18. Ani chal Rabbi Meir, el Rabbi Yossi, Shavsi Ravi, but according to Rabbi Yossi, it's only 17. Ikra adaha de Ravacha Barada, damar Ravacha Barada, amar Rabbi Yitzchak, gazu al pitam, mishum shamnam, they put a decree for the food because of the oil. So they forbid the food, the bread, in order for them not to eat the oil, ועל shamnam mishum enan, and the oil from the wine. Al pitam mishum shana ma'ilum and the shemen nifat. What's the difference between the oil and the bread? Ela gazru al pitam v'shamna mishum enayim. The whole gzera for food and the bread and the oil, it's because of the wine. It's like siag, it's like boundaries that they put. V'aliena mishum notehem. The reason for wine, because drinking wine and intermingle and the next thing. V'al notehem mishum davar acher. And the reason that they put the decree for their daughters, it's because people worship idols. You remember the story in the Torah, how the daughter of Moab seduced the Jewish people when they asked him to worship their idol. The other one is because of the worship idols. Worship idols is another reason, not worshiping idols. So it's like a separate decree. My davar acher, what's the other? Amar Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak, gazru al tinok nochri, even this baby doesn't have the discharge, but it's already put a decree. Why? That they not get together. The whole idea is that sometimes you get close and they have this issue of mishkav zachur, homosexuality, etc. יהכי לרבי מאיר נמי. So if that's the case, so the, all these drawing water, that if someone forget, and you remember we talk about the raining water that come, and if someone forget, tashtis rabbi, so you have 19. So he responded, he said, no, ochalim v'kelim shnu mashvikim b'chad v'chashiv lu. The two, last one we said, that the utensils and food that touch a liquid, b'chad v'chashiv lu, it's all wrap up as one thing. So in conclusion, what we study so far before the Mishnah, we study that it's a machloket between Rabbi Akiva and Rabbi Tarfon. If a farmer go with a mardea, and the mardea come upon the other side of the grave, so according to Rabbi Tarfon, if you go by the Rashi, it's tumat erev, one day midoraita. According to the Tosfot, if the shelo bechiburim, it's pure. Bechiburim, you need seven days in the Raita. And according to Rabbi Akiva, if it's not bechiburim, it's the rabbinic, and it's 7 days. If shelo bechiburim, if it's not that it's attached, so it's 7 days from the rabbinic, and bechiburim, it's 7 days from the Torah. Now, if someone is dealing with wine or with oil, right? So he needs to use a pure vessels or not. So if you go, I just put the conclusion, the synopsis of, if you go by Shammai, so he has to do it in pure. According to Beit Shammai, Legat is pure, but Hillel, before he agreed with Shammai, he said, no, only Betahara. Why? Because he doesn't want to lose. But then he changed. Then we learn about the 18 things that Beit Shammai and Beit Hillel, and we have a different opinions of the 18, how they count and what they involve with the count, the 18. Now we're going to the Mishnah. If someone about to do some work before Shabbat, and that work continue during Shabbat, so it's a different opinion, dispute between Beit Shammai and Beit Hillel, what's the situation? We allow, not allow, in what condition? Beit Shammai אומרים, אין שורים דיול וסמנים וחרשינים כאלה כדי שישור מבעוד יום. Beit Shammai hold that a person should not have soak ink, dye, or vetch, unless there is sufficient time for them to become fully soaked while it's yet day, and Beit Hillel allow it. So, just again, I'm stopping for a second and give you some introduction. In the Mishnah, we find a fundamental disagreement between Beit Hillel and Beit Shammai regarding the following question. Must one begin refraining from actions prohibited on Shabbat, on Friday, on Shabbat Eve, or may one initiate an action prior to Shabbat, even if he knows that it will somehow continue on right in its own Shabbat itself. So the source of this dispute is a Torah, it's a biblical passage that prohibits creating activities on Shabbat, not only for household members, but also for animals and that belong to a Jewish person. For example, the Torah said in the Shemot in Exodus 20, and also in the Deuteronomy in Dvarim chapter 5. So Beit Shammai extrapolate the idea to obligate a person in which we call Shvitat Kelim, that a person's object must, quote-unquote, rest on Shabbat. That is, he cannot drive benefit from work performed by objects and implements belonging to him on Shabbat. That's a concept that's rejected by Beit Hillel. So the Mishnah teaches us, Beit Shammai says, one may only soak dry ink in water, and dry plants which produce dyes in water and veg for animals' food, to soften them in water on Shabbat Eve, adjunct to the Shabbat, if there is clearly sufficient time for them to soak for their designated purpose while it is still day before Shabbat begins, and their continuous soaking on Shabbat will have no effect. So in Beit Hillel permits doing so. And then I'll just give you the abbreviation of the Mishnah, we're going to read it soon. Beit Shammai said, why may only place bundles on the combat flags inside the oven on Shabbat Eve if there is a sufficient time, so that they will be heated while it's still day? And one may only place wool into the dyes kettle if there is a sufficient time for the wool to absorb the day while it is still day. And Beit Hillel permits doing it. Beit Shammai say, just give you the point that one may spread traps for animals and birds and fish only if there is a sufficient time remaining in a day for them to be a trap in them when it's still day. And Beit Hillel permits doing it if there is not sufficient time remaining in a day. Beit Shammai said, why may not give a skins to a non-Jewish tanner, no clothes to a non-Jewish dry cleaner, unless there is a sufficient time to walk them to be completed while it's still day before Shabbat begins? And in all, Beit Hillel permit doing it with the sun, which means as long as the sun is shining on Friday. Let me give you the halacha, and then we just read word by word the Mishnah. The halacha follows the opinion of Beit Hillel. So on Shabbat Eve, while it's still day, it's permissible for a Jew to give an item to a non-Jew, so that the non-Jew will perform the labor and that's prohibited on Shabbat on the Jew behalf. However, a Jew may not insist that he performed the labor specifically on Shabbat. In addition, if the non-Jew is a regular employee of the Jew, it is prohibited. And that's the Rambam said in Hilchot Shabbat, chapter 6, and also Shulchan Aruch Or HaChaim in chapter 244. Now, with that in mind, we can read the Mishnah, and I think it will be easy to go word by word. So the first one, we say that ain't showing drawing with some yachoshinim. One may not soak ing and vaj unless there is sufficient time for them to become completely soaked while it's yet day. Beit Hillel matirim. Beit Shammai we nutnim munin shel pishtan l'tochnu rak kedei she'yabilu bod yom. Sufficient time for them to heat it while it's the day. Ve'lo destemer lo ira, and not the dye vet, ela kedei she'yiklot ha'ayin, that it's absorbed the color in the eye of the day. Beit Hillel permit it. Beit Shammai we nutnim en pursim metzudot chaya ve'ofot. Vedagim, one may not spread the trap of beast and the bird and fish, ela kedei sheyitzodu mibeod yom, and this is sufficient time for them to trap in a day. But let allow. Beit Shammai amrim en mochrim lanochi. Beit Shammai said on Friday you should not sell an article to an non-Jew, etc. And to anim emor you not load the animal. Ven makbim alav, don't put load upon him, la kedei sheyagel makom krov, come close place. And please read in my book. Biurei klomar berashi al hashas. In that book, I give an explanation for this Rashi. Rashi here said, "Ela kedei sheyegei lamakom karov, klomar kedei sheyegei lamakom karov sheluchem misham beod yom." That place will be closed, so he can carry on the day. And what does that mean, karov? Exactly, that's what Rashi said. We are running out of time. Ubeti lematirim, beti lelaud, and then Beit Shammai amrim en notnim orot leabdam. You not give a hides to a tanner, an un-Jewish tevelokin mechoves nochi, not the clothing to a launderer or dry cleaner, ela kedei she'asum yod, only if it's made before Shabbat. Bechulam beti lematirim im hashemesh. All beti lelaud, when the sun is still up. Conclusion, Amar Rabban Shimon Gamliel, Rabban Shimon Gamliel said, Noagim ayu beteva, the practice of my father's household, שהיו נותנים כלי לבן לחובס נוכרי שלושה ימים כל השבת. We used to give it 3 days before Shabbat. Make sure they don't do it on Shabbat. ושבינו ואלו both, בית שמאי ובית הלל agreed, both concurred, שטוענים קורת בית הבד ועיגולי הגת. That we may place the beams of the oil press, right? So it's basically crushed the oils and the circulate planks of the wine spread on Friday afternoon. Even if you think about it, all this liquid later pressed and it was already Shabbat, they allow it. And Rashi elaborates on that. We're running out of time. I encourage you to read the Rashi here. Yes, we learned a lot today and many halachot, some of them. The idea of Tum'at HaChiburim. Reuven, Mr. A, and Mr. B, and Mr. C, Mr. A attached the dead body, and how is that transfer in different level? We learn about Umar Deol Ktefo, Rambam said, Ilchot Matnot, Tumat Met, chapter 12, that the sages decree that one who carry around pole, one end of which is over a corpse, you know, a dead body, becomes impure with impurity like that caused by a tent over a corpse. So this applies only if the pole's circumference is the hand breadth in the size of tefach, as per the opinion of Rabbi Yanai. However, it only transmits impurity to another person or vessel beneath its tefach, the hand breadth, that's the Rabbi Akiva. Another one, it's Habotzer Lagad, one who harvests grapes to take them to the press. If one gathers grapes in order to squeeze the liquid out of them in a wine press and juice seeps out of them and the juice renders the grapes susceptible to ritual impurity, the reason for the stringency is the people squeeze these grapes for various needs and have an interest that emerging liquid will not spill. Since we want these liquids, they render grapes susceptible to impurity. So that's again that the Rambam Sefer Torah Ilchot Tumat Ochlim, chapter 11. Another important halacha we learn, it's the gzerot. The rabbis put in several gzerot in the fear that it will be some type of intermingling which lead to marry out of faith. And therefore they put boundaries over food, over wine, over other things. Wine is another phase which is the idol worshippers, but it was mainly the whole issue of discourse and the relationship with and the same applied to the daughters, that a prohibition against marry out of faith. Again that's Shulchan Aruch Ben Ezer, chapter 16. Now another, this is a real practical halacha. Rabbi Ovadia Yosef elaborated that at all. I mean, many times I heard him speak about it. Asiyat melacha erev Shabbat im chashicha, performing prohibited labor on Shabbat Eve at nightfall. It is permitted to initiate a prohibited labor prior to Shabbat, even if it continues on its own and it's completed on Shabbat. That's the opinion of Beit Shammai, and that's the Shulchan Aruch Or HaChaim 252. So, one, in general, we say that on Shabbat, what is still there, it's permissible for a Jew to give to a non-Jew to do some labors. But however, we not insist that a non-Jew perform the labor specifically on Shabbat. In addition, if the non-Jew is a regular employee, so it's a problem, it's prohibited, because that's basically, he's the same as him, and that's Shulchan Aruch Or HaChaim 244.
Es Hashem.